Hello everyone. Mira Nikki asks a very important question. How much are you willing to seem for the crazy stalker girl in order to survive? This series claims to infamy is Gasa Yuno and the poster Yandere. And for good reasons. Sometimes she's the secondary protagonist, borderline anti-hero, and sometimes she's potential villain. This girl does everything and carries the show. Mirai Nikki is about a survival game in which the participants have diaries to see the future, specific to their personality. For example, Uryu the bomber has diary that will record her future escape route, while Kurosu the detective has one with future investigation case. And our lovely Gasa Yuno has a diary that records everything about her object of desire, the MC Yuki Teru. This is next level creepy, as he literally cannot escape her prying eyes. So instead, he accepts her affection and turns her into a personal bodyguard, albeit one with personal space issue. Right off the bat, Yuki is not a great protagonist. The series needs him to be vulnerable so the premise could work, but he is awfully incompetent. He is always two steps behind the other characters, whimpering and crying whenever he is faced with any ordeal. In every other episode, there is always a scene of him sobbing or having a mental breakdown. There are many battle royale anime, some with duo protagonists, where there's back and forth exchanges. But here Yuno basically carries the entire thing, just because Yuki was nice to her that one time. I don't mind protagonists that becomes a support, Fate series has a lot of those. And I've come to tolerate cliche anime MC. But it's really hard to invest on Yuki, when he does the same mistakes multiple times and needs Yuno to bail him out every time. Mirai Nikki really hinges on this volatile girl. I have seen so many horror movies or series, but Yuno still gives me the chill. There's duality on everything she does. She might seem perfectly reasonable, her decisions seem sound and pragmatic, but fueled by all the wrong reasons. Yuki, on the other hand, has anime protagonist syndrome. If someone calls for help, he gets all excited and jumps to their aid. Yuno sees through all this bullshit, but you cannot really root for her either, because she's on the verge of losing it so many times, despite all the shoujo anime filter she used on her flashbacks. This unstable symbiosis is actually really interesting. It's like an impending train wreck. Someone gonna mess up and you just cannot look away. While Yuno is the center of the series, the other cast members carry their weight as well. I think Uryu is a bit too extra at the start, but she is slowly becoming more amicable, thanks to several oddly timed yet effective humor. Akise Aru, the self-proclaimed detective, is intriguing as well. He's more suited for this kind of mystery team. Also Hinata, the dark-skinned girl with Kansai dialect, because I like dark-skinned girl and Kansai dialect. Not every arc will hit the jackpot, but they will be interesting to some degree at least. There is enough chemistry and intricacy between the cast for this dead game to work, but it will require some suspension of disbelief from the audience. After all, we have a serial killer incident, school bombing by literal terrorists, and mass cult hypnosis in just the span of maybe 1 week. A few of these instances are far-fetched, to say the least. I appreciate the series for always showing the time and location, but that just makes the time frame more dubious. Imagine the effort to put bombs on specific area on the school, or a brainwashing entire cult, or finding hideouts. Everyone here has hideouts. And the logistics of all this is staggeringly improbable. Some characters will just pop up in the right timing or situation. Then after each incident, it's all wrapped up conveniently. A couple of these events rely heavily on anime logic, that it kinda takes the tension away. But it's also understandable when God is involved and the series needs to set up for the next outlandish situation. It embraces this absurd nature, which admittedly adds to the charm. I really like the epilogue on each episode with Murmur, the childish deity. This is a rare case of anime using the epilogue in humorous way and also complements the character development, while not spoiling too much of their scheme. In fact, these few minutes give more depth that otherwise would not be present in the main narrative, which has darker or more serious tone. I think this is a smart addition and definitely adds more point to the series value. Mirai Nikki is not flawless when it comes to sci-fi or survival game concept, but it's so aggressively captivating. Not often we see a character with such mystique and mystery like Gus Ayuno. Her antics are sublimely menacing, and I would even say she's more terrifying than some monster in horror movies. She carries the series from typical supernatural affair into a cult classic. That's it, thank you for watching. Please leave a like and a comment. Consider subscribing and share with your friends. I make 3 videos every week. Have a nice day, and I'll see you in the next one.